Mr. Excel podcast is sponsored by Easy Excel. Excel In-Depth Chapter 11, Aggregate. Well, hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. Well, Excel 2010 added a lot of functions, but, you know, a lot of those were simply international issues or getting the statistics probability functions to have common names. But the one really, really, really good new function is called Aggregate. So equal Aggregate. And what Aggregate will do is it will do any of the 11 calculations that we had in the subtotal function, as well as some ones that have been missing from the subtotal function. So median, mode, large, small, percentile, and quartile are all available there in the aggregate function. And subtotal has the ability to ignore other subtotal functions, right? That's the default behavior. And also other rows hidden as the result of hiding rows. But the aggregate function kind of goes a little bit better because there's three different classes of things that it can ignore. It can ignore other subtotal rows, like subtotal would do. It can ignore hidden rows, also like subtotal would do. So like this, you know, this basically is the for example, the 9 version of the current subtotal, and this one here would be the 109 version of the current subtotal. But then it does something new. It says, hey, I'll also ignore error values. All right, so the first argument that you're going to pass, just like subtotal, is which of the, well, now it's 19 functions, not 9 functions you want. But then the second argument is which things do we want to ignore? And you see here, based on this little table, we can ignore some things, not other things, and so on. So you find the right value from this table that ignores what you want to do, and then specify the range. Now, you'll notice that a few things down here in red, these items, which generally will accept an array, can be used in an array formula, which just opens up some whole interesting possibilities. I really wish they would have made all of these available as an array formula, but they didn't, so let's just, you know, what can we do there? So here's a range of values, 1, 2, 3, 4, and NA. And if I sum that, of course, the sum of that is going to be NA, you know, as we expect. NA just causes all future formulas to be NA. And even the subtotal function saying, hey, let's, you know, it's going to become NA. But the beautiful thing about aggregate, I set up an aggregate here, and because I use 6, you see that 6 says ignore error values, well then it just throws that NA out and I get an actual total. So there's all sorts of situations where you might need to add numbers up, including or excluding hidden rows, other subtotals, or error cells, or some combination of that, where aggregate is really going to get much, much easier. Well, hey, I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.